Well, thousands of people drive above them every day, but very few realize many of Jackson's homeless are living in the woods under freeway overpasses. Tonight in my special report, what's being done to get the homeless off the streets and the one facility that Jackson desperately needs.
I decided I have some little soap. I need to take a shower today. I haven't took a shower in about 2 days.
A change of clothes and a towel. That's all of Vic's worldly possessions stuffed in a plastic bag. The 28-year-old is homeless and trying to survive in Jackson.
Where do you go every day? I mean, what do you do, man?
Nothing much. I mean, I sleep and hope somebody save me because I need it. I'm hurting.
The city says some homeless choose a shelter, others a city park, and many the woods under a busy interstate overpass in Belhaven.
So we have a record of the number of homeless individuals that's on the street any given night. It's about 700.
Recently, I've seen one person carrying grocery bags and other items into the woods.
For the last 30 years, Joe Curley has called Belhaven home, but a recent crime made him more aware of squatters in his neighborhood.
Evidently, somebody was going through the neighborhood and looking for cash. They didn't take anything else out of the truck.
Here's a clear sign that people have been camping under I-55 here above me. You can see there's trash and debris everywhere. It's this kind of stuff that neighbors don't want to see.
I think it's time that it really be addressed, not just to get rid of the people, because they may be a threat to the neighborhood, but to provide help.
We definitely see people out on the streets.
Rex Baker with Gateway Rescue Mission says addiction to drugs or alcohol keeps many folks on the streets.
Some just choose to live in the woods. They don't like structure. They don't like to come to shelters or programs.
Gateway helped Timothy Holland conquer his demons.
I had a drinking problem, but since I've been here the 3.5 years, it's been a blessing.
Baker says Jackson desperately needs a full-time facility for homeless mental patients.
30 days worth of medication and you're on your own is not a good situation. That's one of the big gaps in services in the Jackson, Mississippi area, is permanent crisis housing for the mentally ill.
Do you think the city should be held accountable for doing more as far as the homeless problem?
Quite frankly, under the current administration, I don't know what they're doing.
We've identified and we know where most of the camps are.
Louis Armstrong with Jackson's Human and Cultural Services Department says the city has a 10-year plan to end homelessness. It includes a proposal for permanent housing for the mentally ill and for people homeless for more than a year.
We've identified a site and we're negotiating with the owner of that particular site to move forward. The owner is actually a collaborative partner of this effort to address chronic homelessness.
If it moves forward, the facility could be built within 18 months.
It's very hard. I mean, it's hard as hell.
Vic continues to walk a lonely path, but he's not giving up on life just yet.
You get put in positions in your life for reasons, you know. You can't let this be the be your downfall. Even if it is your fall, it's still a major comeback. You know, minor setback for a major comeback.
Well, the city says they don't have a specific ordinance that bans camping on city property, but a spokesman told me it is trespassing. Now, tomorrow in part two of my special report, we meet a local organization that is going into some of Jackson's toughest neighborhoods to help the homeless.